Hello, and welcome to the first of a three-part tutorial series which will teach you how to use a laser cutter. This tutorial series was created at the Transformative Learning Technologies Lab at Stanford University. In our tutorials, we'll be using the educational edition of CorelDraw and an Epilog Helix laser cutter. That said, most of the techniques and settings that will be demonstrated are transferable to many other software packages and laser cutters. In part one of our series, we will use CorelDraw to create a cheat sheet of laser cutting terminology. Part 2 will explain the Epilog printing preferences, and Part 3 will discuss how to set up the laser cutter for successful cutting and engraving. Before we start, I'd like to mention that certain parts of this tutorial will go very quickly, and you may need to pause and/or rewind to keep up. Additionally, if you would prefer to read a transcript of this tutorial alongside screenshots, please visit the TLTL website where a copy is available. Okay, let's get started. First, open CorelDraw and start a new document. On our computer, we have already created a document preset for the laser cutter, which provides a page that matches the dimensions of our cutter. If you do not have a stored profile, you can input the dimensions of your engraver in the text input boxes below. In our case, that is 24 by 18 inches, or 61 by 45.7 centimeters, but different machines might have different cutting areas. After your page is correct, press OK. Before beginning to add content, the first thing we'd like to do is set our origin to the top left corner so it matches the Epilog machine. Before being able to do this, we need to make sure that the rulers are visible. To check whether they are, navigate to the View menu and make sure the Rulers choice has a checkmark next to it. Once they are visible, move your mouse to the top left, where you will see a small resize icon. Click and drag this icon until you reach the top left corner of the page. Once both the vertical and horizontal lines overlap, let go of your mouse and your origin will be set. After setting the origin, we can start to add content to the page. Start by selecting the rectangle tool and then click and drag to make a rectangle anywhere on the page. After completing your rectangle, navigate to the top left corner of the screen where there are two sets of input boxes, one for the object's position and one for the object's size. Additionally, you will find a padlock icon which signifies whether the dimensions are locked to each other. If the icon is currently locked, click to unlock it now. Then, change the object size to 3 inches by 2 inches or 7.5 centimeters by 5 centimeters. Once the size is correct, locate the rectangle in the upper left corner of the page by clicking its center and dragging it into place. After placing the rectangle, proceed to the top of the screen and choose 2Fit, which will zoom the screen to our rectangle and make it much easier to see our work as we proceed. Next, we are going to add a circle to the top left corner of the card. To do this, first select the Ellipse tool and then drag to create an ellipse. You will notice that when you first begin dragging, the aspect ratio is not constrained and you can make all kinds of ellipses. Since we would like to create a circle, we need to hold down the Control key, which forces the tool to create a circle. After completing the circle, navigate to the lock icon near the object size boxes, and this time make sure it's in the locked position. Once you have done so, change the horizontal dimension to 0.25 inches or 0.5 centimeters, which will also force the vertical dimension to change. Now, move the circle to the top left corner of your rectangle. At this point, we're going to ensure the rectangle and circle will be cut by setting their outline widths to hairline. Within CorelDraw, hairline is the smallest possible outline width, and if set, the laser cutter will interpret the shape as a cut. To set your outline width to hairline, first select the Pick tool, which can be accessed using the icon or by pressing Control spacebar. Then, hold down Shift and click each shape to select them both. Now, navigate to the Outline Pen menu and choose Outline Pen. After the dialog box appears, choose Hairline as the width, set the color to red, and press OK. Next, right-click the objects and choose Lock Object, which will prevent us from accidentally moving the shapes as we continue to add content. Now, we are going to add a small data table to our card. To do so, we need to access the Pen tool, which may be hidden under the Freehand tool. This is a good time to point out that many of the tools on the left have little arrows in their bottom right corners. These arrows signify that other tools are available if you click and hold on the visible tool. As you can see, the Pen tool is located in the Freehand tool menu. After selecting the Pen tool, draw two vertical lines and two horizontal lines in the middle of your card. The Pen tool works by single-clicking the point where you'd like the line to begin, and then clicking again where you'd like the line to end. If you'd like to keep the lines vertical or horizontal, hold down Shift before clicking the second time. After making a line segment, you will notice that the Pen tool attempts to continue the line as you move your mouse away. To stop it from doing so, press Escape. Now, start a new line with a single click, hold down Shift, single click again to end. Press Escape and start again. Click, hold Shift, click, escape, click, hold shift, click, escape. When you are finished, choose the pick tool and then drag a rectangle that is larger than all of the lines. By doing so, the software will select all of the lines within the boundaries of your selection rectangle. Once all of the lines are selected, press F12 to access the outline properties, and then assign a width of 0.02 inches, or 0.05 centimeters. Now, choose the text tool, which will bring up the text properties in the top toolbar. Before clicking inside our rectangle, change the font size to 16 point. This change will bring up a box which informs you that if you proceed, all new text will also be 16 point. This is fine, so just press OK. Now, click in the top left section of your table and type Corel. Next, continue to use the text tool to fill the remaining cells with Epilog, Result, Hairline, Vector, Cut, greater than 0.001 inch or 0.0025 centimeters, Raster, and Engrave. When they are all entered, you may need to adjust the placement of some of your lines or text so there is no overlap. When everything looks good, we are going to assign different outline widths to our lines and text. First, select the top horizontal line and assign it an outline width of 0.04 inches, or 0.1 centimeters. Next, choose the three words along the middle line, hairline, vector, and cut, and assign them a red hairline. Also, remove their fill by selecting the fill tool and choosing no fill. Next, select the bottom three words, greater than 0.001, raster, and engrave, and assign them a black outline of 0.15 inches, or 0.04 centimeters. Additionally, remove their fill using the fill tool. We can now see the value of setting our hairlines to red, since it provides us with a simple visual reference as to which words will be cut versus those that will be engraved. With that complete, we are now finished with this tutorial and have created a simple table, which will help us to remember whether our lines will be cut or engraved by the laser cutter. The chart reads from left to right, with the top line being the categories. As we can see, if we assign a hairline to a shape within CorelDraw, the laser cutter will consider it a vector, and the result will be a cut. On the other hand, if we assign an outline that is anything greater than 0.001 inches, or 0.0025 centimeters, the laser cutter will consider it a raster and engrave the shape instead of cutting it. That concludes the first tutorial. Remember, if the video went too fast, please consult the written documentation on the TLTL website. Once your file matches ours, please proceed to the next tutorial, where we will discuss the printing preferences of the laser cutter. Congratulations on making it this far!